Welcome back. Let's practice a little bit more with recording transactions and T accounts. Remember, these T accounts are a critical part of your learning accounting, so even if you don't think you need them, make sure you do them, especially when you're doing your homework online or any other exercises. They're just a good habit to get into, and they will help you down the road as we get into more complex transactions. So let's take a look at these transactions. Number one says that we earned $450 of service revenue on account. So the first thing you want to ask yourself is, was there any cash involved in this transaction? The key words to see here are on account. So no cash involved in this particular transaction, at least not yet. But it did look like we earned, because it said we did, service revenue. So in this case, we can start by recording an increase to our service revenue account way down here on the bottom. Now, revenue accounts increase on the credit right side. So we're going to reflect that on the credit right side here with an increase of $450. Next, we're going to show an increase to an accounts receivable account. Now remember, accounts receivable is an asset. This is the amount that's due from our customers, and all assets increase on the debit left side. And of course, we need a debit here to round out. So again, when you're doing T accounts, it doesn't really matter whether you begin with the debit first or the credit first, as long as you end up equaling out in the end. Okay, number two says we received a utilities bill for $225 to be paid later or on account. So here's what happened. We got a utilities bill in the mail. We're planning to pay it probably in a couple of weeks. But remember, accrual-based accounting says we got to record all expenses when they're incurred, and it sure looks like we've incurred these utility expenses. So let's come down here to utilities expense, and expenses increase on the debit left side. So we're going to go ahead and take in and increase that here on the debit left side, $225. Now, we can't credit cash yet because we haven't paid for it yet. So instead, what we're going to do is we're going to take and increase our accounts payable account by $225. Now, accounts payable is a liability, and liabilities increase on the credit right side. Just like that. Okay, let's take a look at number three. Number three is a little different. It says we accrued $900 of wages at the end of the period. Now, when you see this word accrued, don't get thrown by it. Basically, what it means is that these wages were incurred by our employees. In other words, they worked the time, they've earned the wages. But at the end of the period, which is where we're at right now at this point, we've yet to pay the wages. We're going to pay it at some point in the future, probably in a week or who knows when, maybe 10 days from now. But we still need to record these wages because we've incurred the expense. So down here, again, under expenses, we're going to increase the wages expense account by $900. Expense accounts increase on the debit left side. Now, because we haven't paid for these wages, we'll need to record this as a liability. Now, you might think we'd record this in the accounts payable account. But with things like payroll, salaries, wages, we often set up a separate payable account just to specifically track payroll-related expenses because they're often so large. So we're going to use an account called wages payable. It's a liability. It's going to increase on the credit right side. So we're going to take and put a credit to that account to increase it. Just like we increase the accounts payable account on the credit side, we increase this account on the credit side as well. Now, once again, don't worry that your basic accounting equation doesn't balance because this is going to take care of itself when we close the books at the end of the period. Remember, revenues minus expenses equals net income, and that net income will get transferred to retained earnings. There's no need to impact retained earnings right at this point because we're putting things down to the account level, and the closing process at the end of the period will take care of that process for us, so we know that this is in balance. Okay, let's take a look at number four. Number four says that we collected $150 from a receivables. Now, this time, it looks like we actually did get cash, so let's go ahead and record an increase to cash. Cash is an asset, increases on the debit left side. So we'll begin there. Then it says we collected it from receivables. Well, they're referring to this. They're saying that the accounts receivable balance, your customers had owed us $450, and it looks like they made a partial payment on that account. So what we're going to want to do is reflect that as a decrease to accounts receivable, and that's going to be recorded on the credit right side. So once again, the great thing about T accounts is we can look at this balance right now and just look at the net of these two debits and credits, the earlier entry here and then this new entry here, and we can see that our customers still owe us a total of $300 on account, and hopefully we'll get that sometime here soon. Okay, let's take a look at step five. Step five says we paid $225 cash on accounts payable. So again, cash is involved here this time, and this time cash went down. So we're going to reflect a decrease to cash on the credit right side. $225. Now it says that we paid that cash on accounts receivable. So if you're, accounts payable. So if you remember, we had originally a few steps ago increased the accounts payable account. So that was a liability that we owe. And it now looks like with this credit to cash, we're paying this accounts payable down. So what we're going to do is the other side of this entry, we've got to balance out debits credits, is going to be a debit to accounts payable to show that we've now paid this balance off. And again, if you look at this transaction or this T account balance, here's your credit originally, and here's the debit payoff. You can see that at this point, we no longer owe any liabilities for accounts payable. All right, the last entry says we paid $900 of wages. So they're referring to this. The wages payable that we had originally set up as a liability here in account and wages payable, they're saying we're now paying this down. So let's start with cash, and let's credit cash to show that reduction of cash for the amount we're paying out now. This time we actually did have cash. And let's come down here to the wages payable account and debit this account to show that we're paying this payable off. Just like we paid the accounts payable off, we've now paid the wages payable off, and we no longer owe any wages if you look at the net balance there.